thanks to the 65 people
in the Grateful Jays. I hope you get to celebrate so that you can continue to celebrate.
You know what I'm talking about? There's only things in this life that make me happy. That's drinking beer, four-letter words, middle fingers, drinking more beer, and the United States Armed Forces.
Hoo-ah! Yeah, you better know it. Stone Cold Steve Austin from Texas.
One man made Stone Cold Steve Austin extremely happy.
Oh my God. Guys, you guys gonna hate me. I know you're gonna hate me. What's up, y'all? I just got out of the shower. Y'all know what happened when I was in the shower? I forgot to turn the stove off and I burned up my roast. God, did you see the picture of that thing? It was so crisp, wasn't it? Oh my God. Hold on, y'all. Let me go cut out the air because I had to. It was so smoky in here. So give me 1 minute, y'all. Oh my God. But I do have a video that I did. I had made some of my homemade pinto beans. I'm going to edit it. I'm going to bring that to you guys because I'm up in Subway tonight. What? Oh, my God. I said, what? I was so mad. Oh, God, I was so mad. I'm coming right back, guys. Let me turn this air conditioner off. I had to get the smoke out of here for real, y'all. Oh, my God. And then I had to wash my hair because it smelled like smoke. Yes, honey, I sure did. Alberta Stella. I said, I'm going to show them this piece of meat. Boy, they're going to be like, oh, my God, no, she didn't. Yeah, I was in the shower, showering, and I left the stove on. I said, something is burning. And I looked in there, I said, oh, Jesus, not my roast, honey, not my roast. So basically what I had to do was clean my stove, scrape it out, and you know, all the smoke got in my hair. I said, oh, God, look at my clothes. They were ruined. So I had to take me a shower, man. And I ordered Subway, you know, for a door drop to bring by. So, hey, I'm so sorry, guys. But I promise you I will make it up with a gourmet meal. I promise you. I'm trying to get Finest Wine to come, you know, to, you know, collaborate with me. Because he is a professional culinary artist out of Atlanta, Georgia. And he's my baby. I love him. The man can burn water, y'all. He can. I can burn water too, but I didn't mean to burn my meat. Oh my God. I am so peed at myself, y'all. Dang, let me read the chat. What's going on, Cold Monster? Alberta Stella up in the house. Got Prince Daniel. What's up, baby? The 40 is here. Yes, I got new people up in here, y'all. For real, for real. And I definitely got my mods on deck, y'all. Oh my God. I know y'all mad at me. Y'all can't be mad as I am, though, really. But I don't know. For some reason, I got... I don't know what happened. I mean, yeah, I do. I forgot that the stove was on. You know, we all make mistakes. So, but you know, one thing about it, you know, I'm mad. Pay look $25 for that big old roast and the carrots and tomatoes. It was smelling so good. And then I was in the shower. I was like, something burning. I'm like, oh my God, my house on fire. And it was a doggone steak. Not the steak, but the roast. The roast is messed up. But I got some vegetables on deck, y'all. Like some collard greens and some squash and cornbread, but no meat. So I took out some barbecue beef ribs that I'm going to cook later with this meal, and I'm going to present that as an upload maybe for tomorrow, sometime this week. And you guys will see me cook, but y'all see that meat. Oh, my God. I was so mad. All I got to do is just bust out laughing, man. I was mad. I was mad. Tears coming. I was like, man, I took me for 2 hours to present this meal, and boom, here we go. And Alberta said, yeah, you're early. Yeah, but, you know, it's 6 o'clock East Coast time. I should have said Eastern Standard Time. But, you know, at the same time, you know, I was going to go live between 6 and 7 anyway, you know, give or take, you know, a couple of minutes. But I was like, man, I better go and tell my people ain't going to be no dinner tonight. And I know y'all mad at me because I was on like, oh, my God, the steak was going to be so tender. Y'all make your mouth watery. But it ain't going to make y'all mouth watery right now. It'll probably make y'all go run for some water like I did. Hey, 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 hello. We got Cold-Blooded Monsters up in the house. And then we got Alberta Stella. She says, well, at least for me. And laughing out loud. And she says, oh, no. And Prince Daniel said, Carolina Diamond. got to love a good tote, good rosa, but not burnt, baby, not burnt. You know what I mean? And cold-blooded monster says, oh no, yeah, oh yes, I burned it, honey. Oh my God. And you know what? It's so bad. I thought, I said, well, maybe if I, you know, scrape some of the black off that my dogs would eat it. You know, my dogs looked at it and it went the other way. You see, it was burnt so bad they didn't even want the bone, honey. Oh my God. Oh my God. Yes, I know. That's all right, sweetheart. That's all right. Because you know what? With cooking, that's how you learn how to cook. You make mistakes. Even though some people we think can burn, the one little old mistake, and guess what? Boom, y'all. It's burnt. You know what I'm saying? I'm just glad Corey or Bandit Boys ain't here because he'd be clowning me right about now, y'all. And I'm like, oh, no. You know? But anyway, you know, you got to laugh at yourself. Even when you get mad, you're like, oh, my God. What was I thinking when I got in the shower? I should turn this sucker off. You know what I mean? And then our brother said, I said, sorry about the roast. Yeah, no problem. You know, I can come on back with some baby back ribs. You know what I'm saying? With that barbecue from baby back anyway. So, hey, you know how we women get up. We are creative creatures, y'all. Okay? Especially ones that can cook. So, yeah, I'm going to come back later. You know, I'm throwing them right now in the microwave. I'm going to marinate them and, you know, get to cooking them and watch the stove this time, right? I don't know. I guess the shower got so good to me, y'all. I just like. And then I got out, had conditioned my hair, so I had to redo my hair again, you know, hot oil treatment. And I was like, well, I'm gonna go live like this for a minute and tell my people what happened and, you know, blow dry my hair and come back and we'll do, you know, some other type of talking or chat or whatever, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, it's all good, y'all. It is all good. If you have an Instapot, they are wonderful too. You're like, yeah, but I love for some reason, you know, how you put it up in the stove and you put your cooking foil around it or your cooking plastic, and it makes the meat so tender. Potatoes in there, the vegetables, and it was smelling so good, y'all. It was perfection. But I went in this stove instead of having on warm. I had to suck all the way on 425, and it burned up. And it took me almost an hour just to get the smoke out of here. Y'all know what I'm saying? But thank God I have my asthma pump, right? It's not funny, but sheesh, how long were you in the shower? Oh my God, about 25, 30 minutes. Oh my God, it was so luxurious. I mean, so felt so good, y'all. It felt so good. You know, when you unwind from there, you just take a shower and you're like, okay, I'm gonna sit back, eat dinner, talk to my people, watch TV and lay it down. It was that type of shower, you know. I was exfoliating my skin, doing my hair, you know, just doing the woman things in the shower. And I guess, you know, time has a notion. When we went in the shower, it takes forever, and booyah, it took my roast with it. Sorry about the roast, yeah. Okay, I see. Cook the roast, yeah. Cook the roast and burn the roast. Hit that like button, y'all. I appreciate it. If you do, definitely. I got six people with a four thumbs up. Y'all give me two more thumbs up. Six people. I should have six thumbs up. Y'all know when I come, I'm going to come kick that doggone on that your thumbs up. You know what I'm saying? When I come and see you, but, you know, it don't matter. If you don't want to hit it, that's fine, but it lets me know what I'm doing as a young content creator. Yeah, y'all. Yeah, exactly. Yep, that's burnt. If it does, honey, it's more than burnt. That thing is corrupt. You know what I'm saying? No, let me start speaking in German. It was kaput, right? We all have burnt our dinner at least once. Yeah, and thank God for it. Y'all hold on. We got Subway coming. Hold on. Be right back. I'm right back. Okay. I'm coming, coming, coming. No, burnt it. I burnt it.
Oh, that's okay. I got something else.
Yeah. Subway. Subway. Yeah, we go to Subway. All
right.
Yes. Subway it is. Yeah, we just seen like about to come up like I burned it. Like, what? Yeah, honey. Burned it up. Now we ready to eat. Everybody ready to eat. You burnt the food? Yes, I burnt it. So what we gonna eat? Subway. Oh, what? Yep. But anyway, we got a makeup mom and son up in here. Makeup and my mama. Why your wrench is gone? I don't know, but you getting it back, darling. Yep, there it is. You got it back right there, sweetheart. Yeah, honey, I burnt up the dinner. And Cold Blood says, hello, makeup mom. Burnt beyond recognition. You know it. Especially the dogs don't want it, right? Exactly, right. They don't even want the burnt bone. Don't even want it. I burnt beyond recognition myself a few times. I know, right? Don't we all ladies I mean, let's just say, ladies and gentlemen, haven't we all burned it? You know, I remember the very first time I tried to grill. I'll never forget it. And it was easy. My dad said, all you got to do is watch it. All you got to do is watch it. I was looking at my steak board, and I was turning it over. And dad said, make sure it gets well done. And I well done it so much, honey, that the bone was burnt. I must have been like 15 years old, because that's the difference between cooking and grilling. I'm not a good griller. So, you know, I let that, you know, let the men take care of that. I could do a smoked turkey or whatever. Oh, I can grill now if I want to. Somebody watch me. But by myself, no. You put me in the kitchen, I'll burn. But you put me on the grill, I'll do damage. If the dogs turn their noses up, you know. Oh, yes, honey. It ain't no good. No good, y'all. But I'm not going to be on here long, long, guys, because I'm going to come back at you guys about around 8 o'clock, because my girl is going live and I want to be there for her. And I've seen some of you guys' live stream. Makeup Mom, honey, you got it going on. I was up in there in your chat like, oh, my God, Katie Roby, my girl, Miss Freaking Wonderful, teach me how to put my eyelashes on. But watching you, you make it so easy. You know, Katie makes it easy, too. But one time I was trying to do a video, trying to do my eyelashes. I had them all on there, but when I tried to open my eyes got stuck. I couldn't see. So I was like, no more fake lashes. So I'm trying to learn how to do that. And oh my God, it's just one of those days, y'all, when, you know, it's cold outside. You've just been watching so much YouTube. You guys, so I started watching a lot of people live YouTubes, and I went by Jesus Freak. He got a video called Nappy Headed Hoes. It's funny as crap. And, oh, man, I've just been something everywhere today. You know what I'm saying? I started with Tony What's Up to Angel Kiss. I was looking at her for a while with video, and look at you guys' video, Cold Blooded Monsters. I'm in the process looking at some of your playlists. I mean, you guys are so, what kind of word for it? Epic. You guys are epic content creators. Y'all make a person like me just want to stay there all day. And tomorrow's homework, too. We got classes starting up tomorrow, guys. I'm starting working on my 7th college degree tomorrow. So I only got like 2 classes, so I ain't got nothing but downtime. So if you got some content, you know, get to know each other. You don't have to drop your link, because you guys can go and, you know, behind somebody's comment and click on the little dots to take you to the channel. But sometimes it works, sometimes it don't, because I was in James Guy live stream and I was trying to click on it and it never go there. And then, of course, I'm buffering right now because of all the snow in the area. So, you know, if you guys want to drop your link to your favorite video that's, you know, that's live, that you got going around doing great or whatever, go ahead and drop your content, guys. Please do that. Please do that. Because one thing about us here at Carolina Diamond Productions and my family, you know, you guys, my family, to your extended houses anyway, we like to, you know, look at content and, hey, put it out there. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, we leave no YouTuber behind. I'm taking you all with me. When I go 1K, 50K, 100K, whatever God allows me to do, I'm taking all of y'all with me, all right? When I get my reality show, I'm taking y'all with me, okay? You know, I'm not saying I'm going to get a reality show, but if I did, y'all all coming with me, okay? We're going to be famous together. One family, one fight. That's how I like to do it. But, yeah, y'all, I'm going to go pick up some Subway. I had DoorDash coming, but, you know, with the pandemic and everything, I'm not too reluctant of having, you know, people to come to the house or whatever, because you don't know if they've been, you know, been vaccinated or whatever. And then with me just getting over that, you know, I think that's one policy that I'm definitely going to enforce. You know, if I don't know you, then I'll go and, you know, take my own risk by going to the store and get it. And I was looking at the news. Walmart is talking about, guys, having people to bring food to your house instead of using the garage. They talking about coming inside the house. You know what I mean? So, you know, that's just mad crazy. I can't see me, you know, working or somewhere while I'm gone or whatever, somebody coming to my house and bringing food and putting my house and wiping my stuff down and go, even though you get a camera. No. I'm not. That's kind of scary. Somebody, a stranger coming to my house. You know what I'm saying? It's just something you just don't do. You know, I mean, some people like that, you know, coming to the house with me. And that's a scary thing. And it's scary out there these days. You are right, Albert and Stella, honey. You have put that right on the edge, sister. It is scary. You got crazy folks out there doing dumb things and doing stupid things. And, you know, when you got a family and you try to keep your house safe for you and yours, you don't want strangers coming up in your house. Because, honey, me being from Brooklyn, I could tell you some stories about dumb people doing dumb stuff. Okay? But, you know, that's just the way it goes. And I hope you guys have a wonderful Sunday. And I do apologize, guys. We're not having something to show you that what I cooked or whatever. But I promise you, there are many more videos and many more live streams where you're going to see me cooking, because, you know, that is something I love doing, is cooking. Not only was I a quartermaster supply sergeant, I could run a mess hall and all that, but I learned to cook when I was a very young kid, because one thing my mother did taught me was how to cook. She said, how can you take care of a house if you can't know how to cook for yourself and your family? So she was very adamant about that. And honey, she said, all her daughters going to learn how to cook, learn how to do for themselves. That's what you call being an independent diva. When you do for you, you don't need nobody else to do it but you. So, you know, I got to give her a shout out for teaching us that. To marry nut jobs around that get away with too much. Ain't that the truth, honey? Heck, to the no for me on that too. I know that's right, Alberta and Stella. It happens, Carolina. We would watch even if you aren't cooking. Oh, you are so sweet, honey. That's why I love you guys. You guys are the best people in the world here on my channel. I am so blessed. Thank God for you people. I love you guys with all my heart. Y'all know that. Much love. I never learned to cook. I taught myself. There you go, my sister. There you go. You teach yourself. Teach yourself. You know what I'm saying? Exactly. Now, I'm going to tell you, before my mama taught me, honey, I would get up in the kitchen and I'd make a terrible mess. You know, I would try to watch a little cartoon at 4 or 5 years old, even though I had my Easy Baker at the time. I wanted to get into stuff and learn how to make pancakes. So I would take things, would go outside my mama's pots and pans and make those mud pies and stick it in and try to bring it on the stove and try to cook it. Oh, yeah, I got in my butt, you know, spanked for that, you know, or whatever, because my mom didn't play. But she said, that ain't how you do it, girl. She would put me in timeout, ground me. Come on, this is how you do it. She showed me how to make homemade pancakes, how to make them out of box. By the time I was 6 years old, honey, I was flipping them like Chef Boyardee. You know what I'm saying? But mom was always in the kitchen watching me. Because one thing my mom didn't let us do, play in her kitchen. She don't like nobody in her kitchen. That's what type of woman she is. If you don't know what you do in the kitchen, stay out of her kitchen, she says. But by the time I was 9 years old, I could cook better than some women who was 35 and 40 years old. You know, my mother, she's a Southern woman, so she teaches her daughters how to, you know, cook Southern things, even how to make homemade pies from scratch. Because when my mom got up, you got up with her and you learn how to do everything she was going to become. It was called being self-reliant. I need to get my husband to teach me to make bread. You know what? I'm going to tell you something, honey. There is one thing I have not learned to do, but I know it's easy. And at the time when my mom was trying to teach me, I was playing basketball, so I didn't really have time how to make homemade biscuits. She showed me how to do it once. She said, come on stage, let me see how you make it. And I made it, but mine came out too rough because she said I didn't put enough lard or enough vegetable oil in it, and I need to stop. And you pat it. You don't got to pat it so much. You do it, you pat it, and you lay it down. So I know how to do it. I just haven't done it since then. But, honey, I made some biscuits. They came out hard as rocks. I didn't put enough, I guess, buttermilk or whatever in it at the time. But I know how to make homemade cakes, so I'm sure making bread is not that hard. So that is something I learned how to do. And, yeah, and I love banana bread and stuff like that, too. So I really want to get into that. And I talked to Fine as Wine and a couple more people who love to cook all the time, and some people from Brazil and also from my other country I love so much, Philippines. Oh, my God, they got the best food ever, I think. And also people in Germany, you know, some of my friends over there. We said, well, anytime you want to learn how to break, you know, hey, call me. Come on, call me. You know, I don't care. We'll do it. We'll do it. So I got a lot of people want to teach me, but, hey, you know, I want to learn how to do it, and then I ask questions. LOL, my first attempt at buns, I made door stops. Oh, honey, so now you feel me. High five on the Alberta Stella, because mine was not just door stops. They were roadblocks. You know what I'm saying? Oh, my God. Oh, geez. It was so hard. Jesus. Oh, Lord. And I'm telling you, mistakes in the kitchen makes us better cooks. I tell you that. It definitely does. Mistakes in anything is a learning experience. That's why I tell people, don't ever be afraid to make a mistake. As long as you learn from it, it's the best mistake ever, you know? And people are afraid to fail. Why are you going to be afraid to fail? Because failure is the first thing of learning something. So people look at failure like, oh, my God, it's in the world. No, failure is the first step of becoming perfect in that area, you know? So that's how I look at it, you know? People like to look at things negative. I'll take the positive out of anything. You know what I'm saying? Like I burned the steak, burned up the roast tonight. Psh, no problem. I cook some regulars for it. A lot of women are like, I ain't cooking nothing. I'm going to sleep. Dinner's ruined. I'm going to bed. No. Throw it away. The dogs don't eat it. Guess what? I'll cook them something better where make the dogs high with me. Arr, you know? Be like Sealy on The Color Purple. If you aren't willing to make a mistake, then how the heck do you learn anything? I know that's right, Albert and Stella. You put that right, honey. You preach it, honey. That's what I'm talking about. You hit that thing right on the nail when you said that failure is not an absent. Failure is the attempt of learning so you can become perfect. You know what I'm saying? So that's how I look at it. Yep. Precisely. I love that movie too, honey. I'm going to tell you another movie I was watching earlier. Armageddon. Oh, my God. With Bruce Willis and my boy Michael Duncan. Rest in peace. Oh, my God. I watched that movie and another movie, you guys. I don't know if you guys ain't never watched it. No, not Robert Benetto, but is it Antonio Banderas? Antonio Banderas. The other guy. It is Brother, Where Art Thou? It's not, oh God, what is his name? He used to be a bachelor for a long time. The women should think he was one of the sexiest, hottest men. George Clooney, yeah. Oh my God, that movie had me rocking and rolling. Brother, Where Art Thou? Have y'all ever checked that movie out? That movie, it was, ooh, Lord, I was laughing so hard. And they were talking about the Soggy Bottom Boys. They started singing, and George Clooney started doing that banjo thing. Boy, I was laughing, honey. I was laughing. And I love good comedy movies. I do. And people like George Clooney, Robert De Niro, honey, they got me. I think they just sexy beasts of mooches, honey. I do. I just love a good movie. A tall, dark, handsome man. And you know what I'm saying? Lord have mercy. I'd be like, oh, my God, with dreamy eyes like a little schoolgirl, you know? Yeah, and that Bruce Willis, he's something, too. I love Bruce Willis. I love a lot of movies, you know. I do. I'm a movie freak. I love it. That is something I love to do. What are you guys going to do tonight? Y'all going to just chill? Because I know it's Sunday. A lot of you guys got to go back to work tomorrow. Some of you guys are still saved by grace because y'all got snow in the road and you just can't move or go anywhere. But, you know, I know tomorrow is people like, oh, my God, we've been at work since Thursday or Friday and we got to go back to work on Monday and the snow is still out there. I love a good comedy, but I'm especially loving the idiotic fun comedy like Red Dwarf and such. Yeah, I like those too. I'd like those too. And Lifetime movies, honey, I love Lifetime movies. Another thing that I like true crime movies. And you know what? I'm going to take y'all guys way, way, way back. I like movies like old, when it comes to crime like that, I like Who Loves You, Baby, like Teddy, what's his name? Kojak and Hawaii 5-0, Book Em Dano, Barnaby Jones, honey. I mean, I don't even take it way, way back. You know what I'm saying? Oh, my God. What was it? I used to watch it all the time. And it's a black and white Perry Mason. Things like that, honey. Oh, yes. I love it. And Lucille Ball and, oh, my God, The Honeymooners. My Three Sons and Laverne and Shirley. Oh, my God. Let me keep going. MASH and, oh, my God. Everybody wanna go? Well, everybody knows your name. Cheers. I love that show. Oh, my God. I go way back. I just love shows from the 60s and 70s. He Knew Raymond Burr? Get out of here. Awesome. Wow. Ain't that something? Wow. Amazing. And you know what? People don't understand. You know what? I think everybody in the world knows somebody famous. Really. And I'm going to tell you one. Y'all might think I'm telling God the Good One. If y'all friends with God the Good One, I believe he's a famous rocker on YouTube. That boy played that guitar so good and wear that mask. I mean, really. I believe he's up there with Def Leppard and Nirvana because he'd be like, you know. I love to hear him play. I do. You know, I met a lot of famous people. I have. God knows I have. And I'm telling you, honey. And I got people in my family that's famous. But, you know, but when you know a celebrity and you think they're a celebrity and you find out a celebrity, that is the greatest shocker of them all. Because I know when I used to work with Colin Powell, I would meet a whole lot of famous people. You know, when you're in the military, you'd be like, hell, they put their pants on the same way I do. But deep inside, when you're in your uniform, you're like, oh, my God, did I just see, Jimmy Walker? Or did I just see John Travolta? You know, but you got to walk with pride. Like, they're like, thank you for your service. Like, yeah. Proud to serve, but deep down in your soul, you're like, ah! I've been many times I like that because I remember first time I seen Dennis Rodman at Washington Ronald Reagan Airport. And he saw Colin Powell, and I'm sitting there, you know, with my computer guys, my IBM team. We sitting up, you know, communications where they can use the security to talk, right? Dennis Rodman roll up in there, you know, with his swag, you know, him and who was he talking to? That's something, it's a Carmen Electra, whatever her name. And it was walking out Ronald Reagan And first thing Mr. Robin said to Colin Powell was like, "How you doing, General Sir? Thank you for your service." Ooh. And he was like, "What's up, boy?" First thing he looked back at us and said, "You know what? Don't ever dye your hair like that, boy, because something's wrong with that child." And I was like, "Oh, he knows Dennis Rodman." That must have been like, you know, I mean, about 5 or 6 years. You're not used to seeing celebrities when you're working with a celebrity yourself, you know, for his military echelons. Everybody knew Colin Powell. Everybody knew him. And now when I was young, I was like, "Oh, he knows everybody." But, you know, as years got and I got more mature, got older, I was like, yeah, but still, no matter where we go, if I met somebody that was very famous and I had to sit there and put that hard look like, "Yeah, what's up? How you doing?" But inside, I was like, "Oh, my God," you know. But, you know, in the military, you got rank on your collar. You got that very professional. But inside, you're like, "Ah!" You know. Hey, very true. Very true. My dad was a stuntman for Lee Majors. What? Get out of here. Not Bonanza. Oh, my God. Not Lil Joe. Oh, I love him. Him and Audrey Barkley. Yes. Wow, that would be wild to see them like that. I know that's right. And your dad, you said my dad was a stuntman for Lee Majors. So you are a celebrity child, honey. Go ahead, Alberta, Miss Stella. We got a celebrity up in the house, a celebrity daughter. Her dad was a stuntman. Oh, my God, for Big Valley. And I love Nick Barkley and them. And Audrey, oh, my God, that was one of my favorite wrestlers. Down in North Carolina, that's what we do, baby. We watch nothing but wrestling. From Little House on the Prairie to Big Valley to Rifleman to what's that? There's another one out there before my time. All those, I mean, and definitely my family, the biggest person they love when it comes to cowboy pictures is the Duke himself, John Wayne. Yes, honey, I don't know how to react if I met someone famous. Never yet, as of yet. Well, your father is famous. He worked with he's a stuntman. So he's famous. Yes. So you are a celebrity. Maverick. I love Maverick too. Yeah. We got a celebrity up in the house, a celebrity daughter, our brother and Stella. Go, girl. Can I get your autograph? Miss Daddy's Girls, Miss Daddy Girl, Daddy's Celebrity Little Girl. All right. Wow. That is totally awesome. Your dad was a stuntman for Lee Majors in his series, The Big Valley. Man, my mom loves The Big Valley. If I tell my mom that, I'm like, yeah, I know a woman that be in my live chat, and she's my friend, Alberta Stella. Her dad used to be the stuntman for Lee Majors. My mom would go nut crazy. She loves Lee Majors. She wanted to marry him. I said, "Mom, you can't leave my dad for him." "Girl, you know I'm just playing, but the man is sexy, you know." Yeah, very nice. Cold-blooded monsters. And I know Cold-blooded, I know you know a lot of famous people too. I just know you do. You know somebody famous. I know you do. Yes, I'm still here. I'm just cleansing reptile. Oh no, cold-blooded monster. He's messing with those snakes. Oh my God. Him and my band of boys, they love snakes and stuff. And them big old spiders. And ooh, how you do it? Ooh. But you know one thing about you, you're a good person to have around for a woman, because you know every woman I know scared of snakes and spiders. You be just the thing that we need to have when I need to say, "Kill it." You probably won't kill it. You probably pick it up and put it in the, you know, play with it or whatever, try to throw it on somebody. But at least, you know, if I was by myself, then I would have somebody around who ain't scared of snakes. Oh my God. I love snakes. I want to. What? You like snakes too? Get out of here. Oh, of course. I know a lot of famous people. I'm sure you do, cold blooded. Who's the most famous person that you know? Besides yourself. Because in me, we all famous in the eyes of God. I've always been the type of person, I get excited by seeing a celebrity, but truly, at the end of the day, I always look at it like this, put their pants on the same way as we do. I had pet rats and mice. What? Oh, my God. Oh, I love you, honey, but you know what? I got to give you nothing but salutes, because you know what? Even though I may been in the military for so long, I'll call you the real service member, because this is a girl scared of rats, spiders, snakes, whatever. Bugs, period. Ew. Oh, my God. Eek. And don't say that about no mouse. I'm running the hell up out of here if I see one. I don't know why I won't say all women, but most of us women, we're scared of mice and snakes and stuff like that. I don't know no woman who ain't. Well, my mother, she's not, but at first she was. The only things I don't like are spiders. Ew. See, I knew it was something that you didn't like. You spiders, snakes, snails, I don't care. Bugs, I don't want them around me. Oh my God, I respect the ones that y'all love them. I know God got a purpose, everything, but for me, I don't want to see them. I'm running. I was running the other day, I guess about 3 weeks ago. I was home by myself cleaning, you know, for, you know, wiping down because of COVID, whatever. And I seen this big old spider outside my house. You know what I did? I said, everything I had in my hand, I dropped it. I did. And I had to call my brother, come and get it and bring it in the house. He was like, you got to stop being such a wuss, girl. It's just a doggone spider. Hell no. When I see a spider, I'm like, the devil is a lie. I got arachnophobia to the fifth power. Eminem, Mike Epps, and a few others. Oh, that's what's up, man. I love Mike Epps, especially on Friday. Man, I hate because Debo gone, though. Y'all know Debo, Tiny Lister, he passed away. And every time I look at Friday, I cry. Why, Monstars? Are you from in California right now? And I know my friend McHenry Cruiser, he knows a lot of celebrities, too, you know? I mean, I know some, too, you know, in my family, like Fantasia, Jodeci, Cedric, Haley. Who else? Let me see. I mean, they're not as famous, but you know these people. Randy Travis lives up the road. I'm gonna love you forever. You know that guy? Forever. He lives in Marshfield, right up the road. Michael Jordan, we see him all the time. Oh, my God. Cam Newton. I mean, shoot, we got celebrities. North Carolina, we got lots of celebrities around here. But I'm talking about them big stars like Julia Roberts and Betty White. You know, I'm talking about the icons, you know what I mean? People that make you like, let me see who I call somebody real famous. Johnny Cash, he would make me stop in my tracks. I love that man. I worship the ground he walks on. I love Johnny Cash. I do. Yes, I do. Let me see who else. DMX. If I see him, I would drop. Rest in peace, brother. But if I would have saw him, I would just drop. Because these are people I look up to. Not because of what they've done, but what they do, you know, what they do to the community and giving back all the time. Michael Jordan, I've seen him a couple times, so I'm used to him. You know, I mean, that's just growing up and loving basketball. But, like, let's see. What's the most famous person I could think of right now that everybody knows and adores? Burt Reynolds, he's gone. I love him. Oh, my God. Let's live. Dolly Parton, I seen her, too. She lives in Grandfather Mountain. I seen her a couple times as a little kid, so I see her now. She's older now. But right now, I guess the most famous person I could think of would probably be somebody like Julia Roberts and Halle Berry. And, yeah, a lot of, you know, yeah, I love Betty White, too. Yeah, I love her. Rest in peace. Y'all know she would have turned 100. And when I saw that she had passed away, I cried. I love her because I've always loved the Golden Girls. I used to watch it all the time, and I still watch it now. I adore Dolly Parton because she's always giving back. Shania Twain. Now, if I see her, Garth Brooks, oh, I'm stopped. Oh, Lord. These are people I love, y'all. Oh, my God. And Tom Hanks. Oh, my God. I love him. Oh, my God. Famous people. Who else? Yeah. Morgan Freeman. People like that. I would just be like, you know. I mean, them celebrities have been around a long time. You know, that's got that superstar and still pushing. You know, I bawled when I heard she passed. Me too, man. I did. And Reba McEntire, I love her too. I love her when she's acting. I love the way she sings too. Yeah, I love her. Oh my God. Yeah, I know I love country. I love all kind of music. But when it comes to like Nirvana and country, I love it. And I definitely love Christian music. I like all forms of music. Those are my top three. I've gone to both of them in concert, but never met them. Oh, really? I love Garth Brooks. Yes. Garth Brooks, he can sing his butt off. Yeah. And what's the other one? I got friends in higher places. Lo, who's seen that one, y'all? Isn't it that Don't Break My Heart, My Achy, Achy Heart, Just Don't Think You Understand. And matter of fact, he got a daughter. And my daughter love him. Because she always playing, she used to play with Britney Spears on the Disney Kids. Garth Brooks sings that Achy Break Your Heart song. I didn't know that. I thought those other guys sing Don't Achy Break Your Heart. He got a daughter. Oh my God, I'm going to tell you his name in a minute. I also love that group, Celtic Thunder. I heard about them too. Yeah, Miley Cyrus. Yeah, what's Miley Cyrus' that daddy name? Oh God, it's not Ricky Cyrus. No, what is his name? Achy Break Your Heart. Yeah, we used to two-step and all that. But hey, Cyrus does the Achy Break Your Heart. Yeah, I know Cyrus, but I forgot his first name. Is it Ricky Cyrus or I don't know? He had a movie out there. My daughters, they love those Disney movies and all those movies. They'd be watching them all the time. And it came out in 2008, 2009. Him and his daughter did a picture together. My youngest daughter at the time was like 14, 15 years old. And we would watch it, and she just loved them. Yes. And the other vampire movie, what was it called? True Blood or something. We go see that all the time. She loves anime and stuff like that. I can't think of the name, but know who you mean. Yeah. Yeah, his name. I want to, is it, it ain't Ricky Ray Cyrus, Billy Ray Cyrus. Billy Ray Cyrus. I said it, Billy Ray Cyrus. Yeah, we thank you, Cold Blooded Monsters. We thought about it the same time. Yeah. Yeah, honey. Mm-hmm. Yes, I love them like that. I really do. And I love I wish they would have line dancing around here, but you want to go line dance, you gotta go place away to Charlotte. And then with the pandemic, they're not having no more line dancing. I think that's the coolest dancing. Put a little mix it up with R&B and line dance, and you got something going, honey. Ooh wee. I love that. I love it. Because y'all did, they got that line dance and they get down with the soul. And it's a good workout, and it's so fun and it's so cool. And I be trying to do the electric slide with the line stepping too. I make my own dance. I'm like, dang, that girl, she got that thing, honey. But I learned that some of those line dancing, boy, it's really hard because they be going so fast. They call the boot, what's it called? The bootlicker shuffle or something like that. I'm trying to learn to do that. And it's a real fast dance, and it is real cool. And Samuel Jackson and who else was in it? They made a movie about it. It was a comedy, and they was doing it. It was the boot shuck boogie or something. Man, it's a cool dance. And people in North Carolina love doing that dance. And it's hard. It is a hard dance. And they were playing the violin, rhythm, like Charlie Daniels. And you trying to get all these steps down. And it is just so cool. I love line dancing. I do. I think sometimes it's better than just going to a disco or something. Yeah, boot scoop boogie. There we go. That's what I'm trying to say. Yeah. I just know I do some of the dance. I just don't know what it's called. You know, I guess maybe because I'm getting over the age of 40. And, you know, once you get 40, we're like, it's a dance. We just dance. You know, when we were little kids, or when we were 18, 21 years old, we used to know how to do the prep and the butterfly and all this and whatever, you know, the whatever you call them old dances when we were growing up, you know, the names. But now when you get at age of 40, you be like, you do your own little thing. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we ain't got no name to it. You just dance it. I can't dance to save my life. I bet you can. I bet you can. Can you, what do you call it? When you dancing with your partner, you slow dancing, and you call it the beach music, the beach boys call it. Can you do that type of dance, the swag, or what do you call it? And your husband turn you around, you dancing to beach music like the beach boys or something. Yes, and you can dance. We all can move our booties. Jesus freak, he's my friend in Canada. You guys might know him. He's wanting to eat the lint out of his buttons or whatever. But honey, he can dance. And you know what? He's Canadian, and he can move just as good as some Afro-Americans I know. You know what I'm saying? And people are like, it ain't about the color. It's about the fact that you can dance. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know why people think some white people can't dance, some black folks dance. Because hell, say, I know some black people can't dance, but I know some white people make me look like, oh my God. And I can give you one, Vanilla Ice. Ice, baby. That boy, he be moving and grooving. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes, hey, it ain't about the color. It's about the soul of the dance. You feel me? Shoot. I love to dance with her. What's her name? She be belly dancing all the time. And she can sing just like Christina Aguilera. What is her name? God, she's from the island. She's Spanish. And she be belly button. And she got love her songs. And she can dance. I can't dance and can't hold a tune to save the world and make my voice. What's Shatter? What? Get out of here. We all can carry a tune, honey. I know you can. I know you can. And you probably want somebody you can't sing and probably sing better than, what, Celine Dion or Mariah Carey, you know? Cranny, LO, nope. I bet you. Yeah, you guys, y'all tell me anything. Y'all probably some superstars. How do I know I ain't got the next Shania Twain or the next Beethoven in here. Y'all can tell me anything, but behind closed doors, y'all be in them showers. They be like, yeah, mm-hmm. She shouldn't have signed a contract with Motown or somebody. Sing your butt off. I'm dead serious. I can't hold a tune at all. You serious? I believe you can sing. I bet when you go to church, you sound so lovely. I know you do. I know you do. And we all can sing in the shower. Don't let your favorite song come on. I know mine is just another manic Monday. And every Monday, I be rocking it. When I go to school, I be like, that's another manic Monday. But you give me some bangles. Just another man. I be rocking it, girl. I don't care if I can't tear his cartoon as long as I'm having me some fun. But getting the fact that it's Monday. Well, tomorrow I'll be doing. Guess when I get up in my car? Just another manic Monday. Hey, I have fun. I don't care who care. I don't care who see me. If I'm singing my song, whether it's a good tune or not, I'm going to sing it. Let the world hear it, honey. Because everybody hates Mondays. I ain't lying. I hate Mondays. And Lord, the only way I get through it, I got to play my song, Just Another Manic Monday. What's going on, Uncle Butler Bunzy? I bet you can also twerk. Yeah, I can twerk and drop it like it's hot, too. Yes. I had a couple of videos probably about, a year ago. It was Twerk City, baby. I love turkey. Drop it like it's hot. Yeah. I sure can. Never tried a turk too. Dang. Old. You ain't never too old to twerk. I got an auntie, honey, who's 65 years old. She can twerk just as good as some 20-year-old. I'm serious. Honey, ain't about the age, it's about yourself. You want to twerk? Twerk City, baby. And if anybody can do the spinning Rooney like the Undertaker, honey, please believe me. I believe you can dance. Yeah, age ain't got nothing to do with it. Matter of fact, I know this guy, 96 years old. I'll never forget it. He used to be a World War I veteran. And we was at VFW one day, and all the veterans had to come out. And they was dancing with their wives. How about this young man, this beautiful soul, 96 years young. Honey, he turned the place out. Him and his wife was out there lecturing. And honey, they don't look a day over 70. And they was 96 and 97 years old. God had his hands on them. That's why that is. You live a good life. You serve a good life. You live a good life. You know, I've always been taught that age is only a number. It's how you feel about it. And honey, they was all loaded from that James Brown. Come on, shoot. He was like sliding just like James Brown. I was like, get the pops. Hey, he had everybody up on the floor. He had the club hot, VFW. He had people 80 years old with the canes out there. Thought they were about 45 and 50. You know what I'm saying? True. Amazing, but true. I wish that I was that brave. Never know till you try, Alberta. I heard that, Uncle Butter Bonds. Yeah, Alberta, she can. Yes, you know she can get out there, Alberta and Stella. Shoot, they be like Stella. What's it, Fred Astaire? Probably doing all that. I know she's good at singing and dance. I could just feel it. I'm over 50 with the bones and body of an 80-year-old, so to speak. Now I already know right there. She already told us, talking about she got 50. She got the body of a 30-year-old and probably sing and dance like a 20-year-old. Mm-hmm. And her Uncle Butler Buns. Hi, by the way. No, I enjoy life as much as you can, LOL, but I am a little chicken shit and embarrassed easy. I embarrass easy sometimes too, honey. I get shy. I do. I can speak in front of people. When it comes, it's like singing in front of a big crowd. I can't do it. I can talk all day. When it comes to singing, if I'm in church, yeah, but singing in public, I'll choke up. But I don't know why. And I can sing a little bit. You know, I'm not going to say I'm the best singer, but I'm not worse. But, Somebody's like, sing a song. I'm like, oh, huh? I got to think about it. And I'll start laughing a while, and then I'll do it. I'll try to get through my shyness, but honey, I get shy too. And I'm a person who can speak in front of thousands of people. But when you say something, I'm like, oh, I'll get shy as crap. And dance in front of a lot of people. I'm just a private person. Yeah, I get shy a lot, you know. I'll get out there and give speeches or whatever. That's no problem. But when it comes to doing things like to put yourself, like, sing in a big, large crowd. Oh, no. And I got to know you to really twerk. I've been drinking some. Facts, honey. I got to have some of that liquid courage, get some of that shadows out of me, do things like that. It took me 10 years to be willing to actually put my first video online, LOL, and I didn't even let my face show. Well, look, see, you overcame that. That lets you know, and when you got to do what you got to do, you don't let shyness hold you back. You're a private person. But when you got to do what you got to do, honey, you let God be your guide. And that's what makes it so beautiful about it, Alberta. You're a beautiful person. I can see that already. You're caring and you're just amazing. And, you know, you're God sent. You're a special vessel for God. And you use your gifts for the gift of God and not for others. And that's what makes it so special. So that's what I'm saying. Yep. But y'all, you know what? I'm gonna stay on about 15 more minutes. I gotta go get this food, y'all. I'll probably come back on. If I leave now, I'll be back by 8 o'clock. But if I stay on 15 more minutes, I ain't gonna bore y'all. I done been on like live like 3 or 4 times. I know y'all get tired of my face. And then, you know, I wanna roll my hair and I ain't gonna see me in no hair rollers. No. I throw up in a ponytail for that happen. And my nose is like, oh my God, running now. You guys know I was sick, but I'm not sick like that anymore. It's just that I had to take that last bit of the antibodies. And then, you know, I take it right before I go in the shower. And what it does, it drains all of the, you know, the cold or whatever that was in your lungs. It's a lung cleanser. I don't know what to call it. Lung purge is what my doctor called it. It is the most nastiest, yuckiest green stuff you ever put in your mouth. It's worse than when you're 6 months pregnant. Our ladies in the house, who's 6 months pregnant, you got to take that nasty glucose before. You got to take a diabetic check. That's how nasty it is. And I took that stuff, honey, got up in the shower. Oh, the mucus came out. And I was like, oh, I can go from falsetto to soprano, you know. My lungs just felt that good. And then when I get out, now my pores are open and now I'm feeling a little hoarse. So I got to be very careful when I go outside. So, and the doctor told me that. So he said, if you feel like you're getting cold, stay in the house and, you know, you take wash your hair, stay in the house another week because you don't want your pores to be open. So, you know, antibodies are building up, but still, you know, your body's still fighting, you know, the purging the rest of the, what do you call it? I hate to say the word, but the COVID, you know, but even though I tested twice negative, so I'm very happy about that. So with it being cold outside, maybe I should stay in the house. You know, see, I see myself coughing now, but not as bad as it was. What's going on, RKH? RKH, like RVD. See, I've been watching too much wrestling. It helps purge the goop out of the lungs, yep. LOL, Uncle Butler. Agree, Alberta. Go get your food. We will see you when you come back. Huge hugs and go, girl. You're right. Before it gets too late, yeah. And I'm going to throw my hair in a ponytail because you know what? And put my beanie on my head and wrap up real tight, guys. Y'all, I'll be back in 1 hour. Give me an hour and a half. I'll be back. I'll look presentable. We'll stay as long as you guys want to, okay? Let me go get this food because I need to eat and I need to feed, you know, my company is here. My cousins, they didn't watch football or whatever, so they ready to eat. So I'll be back in an hour and a half, guys. Much love. Peace. I promise you guys, I got something to tell y'all anyway, all right? Salute. Much love, y'all. I'll be back in an hour and a half. Peace. What?